So today, you know it's a cleaning video when I started by laughing and having a shame spiral. No, not really. I'm laughing at, no, not at myself, with myself. Oh, it's another embarrassing cleaning video. Welcome. So today, I'm taking you with me as I clean out, declutter, deep clean, all of the, wait, I already said clean. What else am I doing? Reorganizing my closet, which is just a whole thing. And I did this last year and I learned a very valuable lesson that just going through my closet and flipping through it and taking out a couple things, I don't end up getting rid of anything. So this time I learned my lesson and I took out every last piece, like every little tiny piece out of my closet, and I completely decluttered, deep cleaned my closet, reorganized everything, and I got rid of a lot. There's a lot I wanna say, but I don't want this intro to be 5,000 years long. But okay, first of all, if you've been here before and you've watched my cleaning videos, welcome back. So happy to have you. If you're looking for any sort of inspo or you like those before and afters that are pretty drastic, this one's a good one. Really embarrassing, but a good one. Because I let my closet get way out of control. Yeah. And I let some dog hair accumulate on the floorboards. So we're there. Okay, if you haven't been here before, a couple things I just want to mention really quick. Number one, I'm definitely not telling you how to organize or declutter your life. I don't want to tell anyone what to do because I'm still learning. I am I'm not a very organized person, but I'm trying to be. And so I'm just kind of taking you along with me as I go through this journey, trying new decluttering techniques, new organization techniques, maybe even folding things a different way. Also, if you're new here, just wanted to throw out there that I do a voiceover style video. So as I am cleaning, I talk my way through it. I talk about what's going through my mind as I'm decluttering, how I'm decluttering, how I make my decisions, which girl's a Libra, so I'm pretty indecisive about everything. So it's a challenge. Just little tips and tricks or things that I found worked. So that's kind of how I do it. So if you don't like voiceover style videos, no big deal. The girl can talk. I get that it's not for everyone. You can hit the mute button, rock out to your favorite music, play a podcast, do whatever you want. If you're just wanting to watch somebody speed clean and declutter slash organize all the things. Also really quick, I didn't end up showing my husband's side of the closet, which I'm really wanting to do. Like how I organize my husband or partner or significant other, whatever you have out there. If you're sharing a closet with someone, I wanna do a video on that. But I'm gonna let my husband declutter his stuff first, which he hasn't gotten to yet. So I'm hoping I'll be able to do a video on that sooner than later. All right, so before I get into this, I wanted to show you the before. Just a lot of stuff piled everywhere. So I had a ton of stuff piled up over a chair that you couldn't even see anymore. It was so covered. And then I had some laundry baskets that were on the floor and things just started getting piled on top of that. So it just looks like a huge mound. And then there were shoes everywhere. I just derailed is basically what happened. It looks really bad. Oh God, it's so bad. Okay, but anyways, that is why we're here, to clean out this closet, get it together, get a good system in place, and get something for myself that's a little bit more realistic. Still going to look the after photos. You're still gonna see a lot of clothes in my closet. I have a lot of work to do still, but I did get rid of two huge trash bags of clothes, plus a huge mound of clothes that I'm gonna be selling over on Poshmark and Depop, which I will have the links to those down in my description box if you wanna check them out. And yeah, that's what I'm doing. Anyway, so if you wanna see how I declutter slash clean slash reorganize my closet in 2020, then just keep watching. All right, to start my closet clean out, I first went through and just grabbed any clothing item that wasn't hanging up. So anything draped over chairs, on the floor, anything like that, I just grabbed a pile of clothes and just threw it all on my bed. And you're gonna see here that I really made my dog upset. She was not having it, but she also wanted to stay on the bed. So it was a whole thing, but I had to get through it. Anyway, so I'm back. Oh, this is so bad. I don't know how I let it get this way, guys. This is so bad.
Oh no. Okay, yeah, just sorting through more stuff, picking up anything that I can find and bringing it into the room and putting it on my bed. And my initial plan was to take everything, even hanging up and putting it on my bed and going through everything at the same time. But I realized really quick that I ran out of room on my bed, and so I just started here. All right, so once I got anything that was just a stray piece, so anything that wasn't on a hanger or didn't have a place yet, once I got that all piled up on my bed, I started sorting things into categories. So first I started grabbing all tops, any sort of top, tank top, t-shirt, sweater, long sleeve, crop top, all tops. I just gathered them in my arms until I could get it to where all tops could be on the left-hand side in a pile, and then all bottoms could be on the right-hand side. So on the right-hand side, I had pants, shorts, leggings, skirts, anything like that. If there was anything like coats or tights, socks, anything like that, I kind of threw to the side for later. But yeah, and at this point, I'm not decluttering anything. I am just grabbing whatever it looks like and sorting it into categories because I'm eventually going to go through all of my tops together, then all of my bottoms together. And yeah, here just still sorting everything that I had found on chairs, on the floor. Not a lot was actually touching the floor. It was maybe like piled in a laundry basket, but all clean. You know what I mean? Hadn't been put away. And or piled on chairs or piled on other things and just didn't have a home. And that was the main problem that I figured out when I was going through everything. And another problem I had was for a while I was doing the whole one in, one out thing where every time I would get something new, I would get rid of something old or something that was too similar or I didn't want anymore or whatnot. But I quit doing that around, like when things got busy around Halloween time through the holidays, I did not even think about it. So when I got more clothes in, I just kind of would pile them up and just be like, I'll deal with these later. And I'm out of ways to talk myself out of how bad this is. Oh, why am I like this? Okay, so it ended up being on the right-hand side, I had bottoms, in the middle, I had dresses, and on the left-hand side, I had tops and a whole mountain of tops, it looks like. All right, so since I had more tops than I had bottoms and dresses, I kind of set the bottoms and dresses to the side for a little while and went into my closet and just started grabbing anything that was hanging up that was a top. So, tunic, crop top, tank top, short sleeve top, long sleeve top, all the things, basically ponchos, whatever, sweaters, sweatshirts, dresses. I took dresses as well. Wait, no, I didn't. I put them back. I basically just took all of the tops that were hanging up and added them to the mountain of tops that was forming on my bed and just kind of threw them all there. And here I was just focusing on grabbing anything from the dark side of my closet. So these are all of my black items. I figured I would tackle my colorful items once I started getting this pile narrowed down because it started getting a little large and in charge. So I just dove right in and started sorting through all of my black tops, basically, or black and white tops were in here as well, and just started pulling each item, looking at it, and sorting it into, I think I had four different piles. I had a donate pile, a keep pile, a maybe pile, and a sell pile. Those will be the items that will go on my Poshmark that I need to take photos of and all that kind of stuff. And in my maybe pile, I have items that I will try on later, or maybe it's an item my husband and I shared. But mainly, as I'm going through this, it's pretty obvious the stuff that I really don't want. But what gets me when I'm sorting, and I'm a super indecisive person, so what really gets me is when I really like something, I just don't wear it that often. And it's especially hard when you work from home because I totally wear these items when I actually go out. But since I work from home, I don't always end up wearing a fancy witchy dress as I'm, you know, sitting here doing a voiceover. But I totally will if I'm going out, you know, going to a show or doing something like that. So what gets me is when I really love an item, but I don't wear it very often. And then at that point, I have to ask myself, when I do go out, why don't I choose this item? Like, why haven't I worn it? And that's when I have to be like, oh, yeah, it's because this skirt is too short, or there's a hole in this shirt, or there's a button missing from this top. And I keep telling myself I'm gonna sew it back on, but am I really? The answer is always no. So that kind of narrows it down for me. Also, do I have a place for this top? Do I even have room in my closet for this top? That question for me gets a little difficult because at this point in my life, I haven't always had a larger closet, but at this point in my life, I do have a larger closet. So that question gets me in trouble because I'm like, oh, I have a spot for it for sure. But it doesn't mean, just because I have a spot for it, doesn't mean that I want my closet to be overflowing or make it so I can't stay on top of it or can't find a hanger for it, that kind of thing. So I'm really not trying to go buy more hangers. I'm trying to use the hangers that I have and the space that I have and not go overboard. So I don't know. It's kind of just going to depend, I always think, on your personality type, how you're going to sort through things. So it might be a really easy solution, like the KonMari method, where you just, if it sparks joy, you keep it. And if not, then you don't keep it. But for me, that's definitely not enough because I love aesthetics and I love clothes and fashion. So every piece sparks joy or has a memory or something attached to it. So it's really difficult to get rid of it. So if I don't have space for it, or I'm making excuses for it when I'm like, oh my gosh, this dress would be perfect if my cousin's dog ever got married in Italy and it was foggy and I needed this. It probably can go. So yeah, that's kind of what I think about as I am sorting through things. So once I actually get the pieces narrowed down, then I start categorizing my tops. So long sleeve tops together, short sleeve tops together, tank tops together, all of that. And then that's when I really start seeing if I have duplicates. And at that point, if there's anything I see, I just go ahead and toss it into whatever pile it needs to go in and then go from there. But yeah, so essentially I'm going through it maybe a second time, but I'm just kind of quickly dividing it up into categories and then can just make a quick decision if I need to. All right, so next I'm doing the same thing with my sweaters, and narrowing down my sweaters was pretty easy since as I was filming this and as I'm doing this voiceover, it is currently sweater season, so I could really kind of figure out what I wore during the fall and winter, what I didn't wear. So any sweaters I didn't wear, if I haven't worn them yet, now that it's basically the end of winter, then I'm probably not going to wear them next winter or next fall. So yeah, it was a pretty easy decision on this one. So after I got through my sweaters, I started bringing the other tops out of my closet. So any colorful tops, or I think I also had white and gray and leopard print and all of the things, just basically the non-dark side of my closet, I started bringing out and sorting through it. Once again, you know, sorting it into keep and maybe and donate and sell on Poshmark piles. Also, side note, since I did empty my entire closet this time around, it did take 500 times longer. So that is the downside to doing it this way. But I really like turning on audiobooks. I've mentioned this before. But here, I think I was listening to decluttering podcasts. So any kind of decluttering or organization book or podcast, I really like because it keeps me motivated. But also if I'm not listening to a decluttering podcast or what am I thinking of? Audiobook, I'll be listening to some like sort of fantasy or psychological thriller, something that will get me locked in and addicted to listening to it. So I want to keep listening just so I want to keep going because I don't want to stop organizing because that means I have to stop listening. So it really does help if you can find a good podcast or audiobook that you're really enjoying and want to keep listening to. But that's besides the point. I was bringing out smaller sections too here. So I was just going in my closet, taking a smaller section, bringing it out, sorting through it, going back. And that was much easier, I thought, because it was less overwhelming and it left me more room to sort through things. Also, once I had a pile of clothes that I knew I was going to keep, I put them in my guest room is where I was putting them. So I wasn't putting them back in my closet yet. And putting the piles in my guest room was really helpful because I didn't get this done all in one day. So yes, my guest room was a hot mess for a couple days, but it kept my closet from getting recluttered right away or my room being cluttered or getting overwhelmed. So if you get overwhelmed by a bunch of stuff being piled up, I definitely thought putting it in my guest room and just kind of shutting that door and then returning to it was much easier than having to go back into my closet or seeing it around my bedroom and just feeling that weight, you know what I mean? And then I just kept plugging along. And then that way, when I was ready to put everything back in my closet, I kind of just went into my guest room and everything was kind of ready to go because I'd already sorted things by color, long sleeve, short sleeve, tank tops, all that was already sorted. So I would just go in, grab a pile, find a place for it. So it made it so much easier to have a separate area. If you don't have a separate area, I mean, the reason why it took me so much longer in reality is mainly because when I have to maneuver a camera and lighting around, it does take a little bit longer than if I'm just going through my closet by myself. All right, so here I'm going through smaller, daintier items, the little spaghetti strap cami things, little bodysuits, crop tops, things that can be lost if they're hung up. So I fold them up and put them in a little drawer in my closet. I didn't actually get a shot of me opening the drawer and seeing a before and after, but this was actually pretty organized because I hadn't accumulated too many little crop tops or little dainty things over the summer or anything. So it was pretty much, I mean, what it ends up looking like. But if you want to see a good before and after for inspo, I'll put a card up at the top for my previous closet declutter. That's a pretty good before and after on that one. Anyway, so here I am decluttering my flannels, which I did end up getting rid of a couple of flannels, even though it kills me inside, but I did it anyway. And also my denim jackets, denim skirts. I have some pants and some shorts and some things that were hanging up. Mainly all this stuff is on the bottom rail of my closet. So I have like a top rail and a bottom rail. This one's kind of that bottom area. Also on the bottom rail, I keep blazers and jackets, which I don't keep my leather jackets or my heavier jackets on the rail, the lower rail, all year round, but it is winter, so I keep them there for now. Anyways, moving on to dresses, we are back in the dark section of my closet, grabbing all of the dresses. This was so hard. So very hard. I love all of my little black dresses, or not so little black dresses, long maxi black dresses, black skirts. I love it all. This is my favorite type of thing to wear. But it was painful. I will say it was pretty painful. Some of the items that were a little bit more costumey, I did end up saving and putting in a separate box for costume inspiration or aesthetic inspiration for Instagram concepts or other cosplay type of concepts I kept. So I might end up over time going through those things too, but I do, sometimes I just get in a rut and I want to look for inspo. So I held on to some of those, I'm not gonna lie. All right, moving on to shorts. I went through, this probably got the biggest makeover because I got rid of all my shorts that were really, really, really short. I think I'm past that stage in my life. Also, the ones that were extremely distressed, I got rid of. I really don't wear a ton of shorts in general. So this is something I'm gonna pay attention to over the summer. But I did hold on to a couple pairs, but yeah, I did get rid of some of these, I'm not gonna lie. So yeah, these are my shorts. All right, what's next? Ooh, jeans. So I grabbed all my jeans and black pants, kind of all put them all in one little category, brought them out and started dividing them up once again into my maybe pile, my keep pile, and my donate or sell pile. So of my entire closet, I felt like it was the easiest to make a decision here, which is maybe it's surprising, maybe not. But for example, my keep pile was for sure like all the jeans that I normally wear, the ones I reach for and the ones that I will wear until they literally fall apart. Those are all my keep pile. And then my maybe pile are jeans that I don't even remember getting them or trying them on or what they look like. I don't even know. So I put them in the maybe pile. I almost said medium pile. I don't know. Maybe pile. And then my donate or sell pile, those are all the jeans that just never ended up fitting right. Maybe they got too old and worn out and have a hole in the crotch or the butt and I'm never going to sew it. Or maybe I don't even know what I was thinking when I bought them kind of thing. Those all go in the donate or sell pile. And then, yeah, so it was pretty easy, I thought, on this one. And then once I was done sorting everything, I went ahead and tried on my entire maybe pile because I figured, why not? I'm going through this now. Might as well try everything on. And so I decided to do a little fashion show situation. So as I was trying on my jeans, what I did is, I don't even know if this is a good tip. This might not be a good tip, but I try to pay attention to any obstacles that would stand in my way if I was getting dressed, for example, and if I just didn't feel good in the jeans. So for example, these I felt like were a little baggy in the crotch. gave a little diaper vibe. I wasn't feeling it. But these, for example, are once again a straight leg, kind of distressed pair, but they don't have a diaper situation going on. So I like how I feel in these and I'd feel confident wearing them. So I kept them. So I kind of kept that attitude as I was trying on these jeans. Basically, if I don't feel good in it, I don't even want it in my closet. I don't want it in my sphere. So if I don't feel good in them, I'm not going to wait for the day that I do. I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of them now and pay attention to the jeans that make me feel really great. So that's the approach I took. Also, what was really helpful was actually filming this because it was more than just the jeans, like seeing how the jeans fit. I saw how I kind of moved in the jeans and reflected kind of how I felt in the jeans. So that was really helpful. All right, so now that I just spent 3 hours talking about jean decisions, we're moving on to leggings and pants. So my leggings drawer, I keep everything, all my leggings, not everything, that would be impossible, all my leggings in a drawer in my closet. And I hadn't really accumulated many leggings or pairs of leggings since I went through it the last time. So it was pretty easy to make decisions here, but I did narrow it down still. I got rid of a couple pairs, which was nice. And I also moved some pairs to my cosplay pile or costume pile, like the gold ones. I don't wear those every day, but I do wear them for costumes and cosplay. So I figured I would put them in there. And also here, just randomly going through some basics that I came across. So some basic camis and some slip dresses, things like that, some biker shorts, and kind of started separating my basics because I wanted to do a whole separate basics drawer. Also going through some pants. These are mainly like dressier pants. Also, if you see any color changing lights happening, it's because the TV is on, but it does get turned off here coming up. I tried to edit around it, but if you do notice some, it seems like a nightclub or something, it will get turned off. I didn't realize the TV was on in affecting that. So anyways, now here I am just sorting through a bunch of socks is what I'm doing. Just matching up some socks and anything that didn't match, I put in a separate pile and I keep all of my mismatched socks in a little bin in my laundry room. So that will be really helpful. I'll just put them in there and hopefully I can find some matches from that bin. But yeah, finding all my match socks and putting them aside for now. And here I'm going through all of my tights. I also have some little like lingerie nighties and things in here as well. I'm going through with my tights. I always kind of stick my hand in the tights and make sure there are no holes or that they're not too distressed or torn up. I did keep one pair of distressed or holey tights, but I didn't keep more than that because I'm such a hot mess that it's so easy for me to rip tights. And all it takes is to wear them a couple times and I already have a nice fresh pair of rip tights. So it's not too hard to come by. And also made sure they were right side out, right? Right side out where they're all lined up. So they'll be easy to roll up and fold later. And that's kind of what I'm doing here. All right, next up, I have beanies and ball caps, and I think I even have a beret or a couple berets in here. So basically just all my hats. And once again, since it is winter time, I have a pretty good idea of what beanies I actually wear and the ones that I don't. So I always keep one ball cap for summertime for when I'm in my garden or doing yard work, just so I don't have sun on my face. And then I got rid of a couple beanies that I never ended up wearing. Since I went through my closet last year, I never wore them, so I just kind of set them aside. And then I kept one beret, and I also keep any gloves in here, but I, per usual, couldn't find any of my gloves. So, but if I do find them, this is where they go. All right, so next up, I'm going through my bathing suits, and this is something I had not done in a very long time. I don't even think I got to this part last time I went through a closet clean out. So I got rid of a lot of bathing suits, some I had had since high school, which is really embarrassing. So what I did is I went through each of the bottoms and each of the tops and decided what matched and or what, you know, sometimes different bottoms can go with a couple different tops or whatnot, especially just plain black bottoms, which is mainly what I ended up keeping. A lot of bright color or design, anything that has a lot of patterns on it as far as bottoms go, it's really difficult to mix and match. Where with tops, I can hold on to more tops and just wear black bottoms with them or whatnot. So the bottoms, I got rid of quite a few of them. And then the tops, I ended up trying them all on, which I didn't end up showing, but I ended up trying them all on, and the ones that still fit me or that I still like the style of, I held on to and put into this little organizer that's from Target. And then the bottoms I folded up and rolled them and then put them in another little organizer that has some dividers in it. And these organizers are from Target. It's like this whole little system they have. I'm not sure if they still have it, but if they do, I will link it in the description box for you. It's such a good way to store bras and underwear or bikinis, like bathing suits, anything where you have cups, you know, like a cupped situation going on. And then if you have like little things like little camis or little bikini bottoms or anything like that, even socks, these little smaller dividers are really great for that. So yeah. Anyways, moving on, I found another one of those dividers that I kept in like that little organizer system. I kept little scarves, like little head scarves in there. So before I was folding larger scarves, and these ones are more like bandana or hair scarf kind of things. So I sorted those and kind of went through those. I also had some shoelaces and bra straps and bikini top straps. So I keep all those in here as well, so I know where to find them. I just keep them in the little organizer areas of this larger organizer. No, I'm just getting confusing. But all right, so now I'm going through my bras and putting my bras in, I kind of just line them up in this little organizer, which once again is from Target. It's just a different color. And I'm just lining up my bras and got rid of a couple of them that were stretched out or didn't fit anymore, or like a strapless bra that I never ended up liking, and kept all the bras that I wear every day, and then a couple little sassy ones that I like to wear on the side. And then, oh, what am I doing here? Okay, here's another little organizer, once again from Target, part of that little system that they have. And I decided, usually my socks are rolled up and put into larger drawers that are from IKEA that you'll see I put my tights in here coming up. But I'd gotten rid of a lot of socks because a lot of them had holes in them or didn't have, I couldn't find a match. So I narrowed down my socks to the point where I could just put them in this little organizer. So what I do to store them is I just take the pair of socks, like one pair of socks, and then I stack each sock on top of each other, and then I roll it up and then put it in the little organizer. And that's pretty much what I do with all different sizes of socks. So even the little tiny workout ones, I just stack it on top of each other and roll it up and put it away. So yeah, moving on to belts. All right, this really needed to be done. I had a lot of belts that didn't even fit right at all. I didn't even own pants that could fit in some of these belts. Like, they were so ill-fitted that I ended up getting rid of quite a few of them. And some of them still had tags on them. I just needed to go through these. And some of them were like torn up and shredding and in really bad shape. So yeah, just went through all my belts and got them sorted. And yeah, that's kind of what I did. Okay, moving on, I went back into my closet and pulled out all of these little containers and also these larger containers that you'll see here coming up that are at the tippy top, like at the very top shelf of my closet. And a lot of these things have shoes, shoe boxes. There are some hats in here, but mainly summer shoes that I had stored away for the winter, like sandals, flip-flops. Sometimes I have some pumps in here, some little slides, that kind of thing. Flats are in some of these. And in the larger baskets or bins, I have some shoe boxes in there. For example, my husband got a nice pair of dress shoes, so he wanted to hold on to the box for that. There's some shin guards and golf shoes and things that aren't worn all the time, but like every once in a while he'll join a rec team or play for a rec team and need some shin guards, or we'll go play golf with my dad on Father's Day. So they're not stuff that's used every single day, but that we have on, you know, stored away when we need it. And then the other larger basket I had just a bunch of empty shoe boxes. Sometimes I'll hold on to empty shoe boxes if I maybe bought a shoe that's a little bit trendy and I don't know if I'm gonna hold on to them for very long. I'll have a box either that can look nice when I donate it, or if I wanna sell it, or if I hold on to them, I might just toss the box, you know, recycle the box. But yeah. Anyways, going through these other plastic bins that have a lot of sandals and flats and even heels and things like that. And I really wanted to narrow it down to one or two of these plastic boxes rather than like four boxes of sandals and shoes or whatever. And this was long overdue because a lot of these flats and sandals, some of them were falling apart, had gum stuck to them. Some of the flats were smelly and stiff and not in good condition. So honestly, I could afford to narrow them down and also afford to get a new pair of nice flats in the instance I end up needing it. So I'm not going to go run out right now and buy some flats because I haven't really been wearing them since I've had some foot problems. But if I ever need them, I really should go get some new ones because, yeah, they were bad. Anyways, now I'm moving on to my tennis shoes, which I keep in one of these kind of cloth bins that go with, once again, the Target organization system that they have or used to have. I don't know if they still have it, but so I'm just taking all my tennis shoes out, and then I had to start making a cut and a lot of cuts. So I kept tennis shoes for indoors, one for outdoors, like an older pair for outdoors, my golf shoes, and I ended up getting rid of these really cute black Nikes that just were way too small. I'm gonna put them up on Poshmark. I kept trying to make them work and they were not working. And yeah, then I store them all toe down in this little cloth basket. And I love storing them like this because you can see everything right there when you pull it out. Love it. All right, next I went back into my closet and started grabbing any shoes that I saw on the floor or elsewhere and started bringing them out into my bedroom and lining them up against the wall and just to get them all side by side. So when I started making cuts, I could see what I had duplicates of and what I was wearing or what I hadn't tried on in a while. And then I would try them on and see if they were too small or maybe they were too big or maybe I just didn't like the style anymore. And yeah, where I really have trouble here, mainly just black boots. I feel like you can never have too many black boots. And even if I have duplicates of the same exact black boot, I will keep them both. It's that bad. But just kept trying to make cuts and cut some really good ones that we'll see on Poshmark that I'm kind of sad about. But I'll be happier when they find a home where somebody actually wears them. So, all right. So here I'm pulling all of my jewelry. I had a bunch of jewelry back here in this corner. And let me just tell you, I made this little jewelry area that I thought was so super cool and amazing. And I never ended up using it. It was just kind of sat in the back corner of my closet and got neglected and piled up. So I don't think I'm going to do that again. I don't know what jewelry situation or solution I'm going to have yet. That is to be determined. As I was going through this, I was thinking about whether or not I had worn a piece in a long time, if I had missed it or ever looked for it or even cared that I hadn't seen it in a long time, that kind of thing I think about. I also looked for broken pieces or jewelry like earrings or necklaces that had missing pieces that I definitely wasn't going to try and repair. I have to say some of the stuff I found later that I didn't even end up getting on camera, but you'll definitely see it next year. I found some of this old 80s early 90s Christmas jewelry that my mom had handed down to me. God, it's so good. Like clip-on Christmas tree earrings. I cannot wait to wear them next year. I'm just gonna hold out. So you, just so good. Okay, anyway, moving on. What am I doing now? Oh, just more shoes. Oh God, more shoes, girl. And handbags, finally getting to handbags. I really didn't get rid of any handbags. I think I got rid of one clutch, a little backpack that had a broken button or like a rip or something, or maybe there was just something that was not working with it. And that was pretty much it. So I didn't get rid of a lot of handbags, but I really didn't have a ton to begin with. But yeah, so here I'm just emptying everything out of this closet, getting everything out, including these drawers from IKEA, which you'll see what I put in them later. But I'm really just trying to get everything off the floor and out of the closet so I can start dusting and wiping everything down, which let me tell you, the dust and dog hair in here, oh my God. It looks like there's actual carpet and it's not. It is legit gross and embarrassing and terrifying. The dust bunnies in here. But I don't know. I'll get over it. This is why we do these videos, right? To make a difference in the world. Okay. Anyways, I was just taking out my husband's shirts, which those shirts on the top rack, those are ones that we actually share. Anyway, so now I am just vacuuming all of the dust up using my favorite thing of life, which is my Dyson handheld, which you know, or maybe you don't, if you're new to my cleaning videos, every single time I do one of these, I talk about how I love this Dyson handheld so much I could marry it. And my husband is not even jealous. No, but seriously, I don't know. Every single time I do one of these videos, I feel like we just go in the comments and talk about how much we love our little Dyson handhelds or any handheld that you have. Let's just geek out in the comments if you want, if you feel me and have one of these things. Best investment ever. It's not even sponsored ever. I hope one day I would actually die if they sponsored me. But it just makes my life easier because I can get in these little nook and cranny areas and not have to lug around a big old vacuum and a bunch of hoses. And it just makes my life so much easier. Although you may not be able to tell because my floorboards. Oh my God. There's an area of my closet my dog likes to lay. And it basically looked like carpet growing on my floorboards. It was very attractive and I'm so embarrassed, but also this is my real life sometimes. And it taught me that I easily neglect my closet and don't think about it for months. So I definitely need to add it to my cleaning routine and stay on top of it because this was not good and I'm kind of grossed out. So anyway, I'm just continuing to vacuum all the dust up and then I'm wiping the shelves down with some all-purpose spray. This is the Mrs. Meyers orange clove scent, and oh my gosh, the orange clove scent is so good. My closet smells like actual fall right now. So good. And yeah, just wiping everything down, getting it all clean. And by the way, as I was in here, or as I'm watching it back, really, about 7 years ago when I moved into this house, I was wanting to paint my closet white. We got hardwood floors put in and I had them paint the trim, like part of the trim board thing, white, and never. Still to this day, I haven't gotten around to painting basically anything, but especially not this closet. And I should have done it while I had everything out of here and everything was nice and wiped down and clean, but of course I didn't do it. But that is something I'm putting on my list. And since I'm wanting to stay on top of my closet and I have way less things, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Anyways, so now I'm just continuing to vacuum, finishing off the floors, vacuuming with my Dyson, the love of my life. And I'm only half kidding. I didn't mop my floor yet. I went through on the floorboards and used some soapy water on a cloth and then dried it off. I like to make sure I dry off my floorboards because water plus wood is just not good. That wasn't supposed to rhyme. But anyways, so just going through and wiping everything down and getting it nice and clean. Then I went through and mopped my floors using the Method Squirt Mop in the almond scent, which is my favorite scent ever. Smells so good. And so once my floors were dry, I started bringing back in my little storage drawers and any sort of containers that I had where I put shoes in and whatnot. So my closet had a lot of hanging space and shelving space, but zero drawer solutions at all in the closet. So I decided to add my own. So I have some of the Target storage solutions that's what I started with. And then I got the IKEA drawers that are on the floor, got those. And I love those because they look pretty modern and they don't look as cheapy in my opinion as like the Target ones are nice. I like them especially for underwear and socks because you can kind of customize the dividers so you can store everything nice and neat, but they aren't as nice looking as the IKEA drawers, my opinion. So now I'm gonna start putting all my shoes back, and this little area here, I like putting all of my favorite black boots in this area, all my witchy boots and combat boots and all of those things. All my black boots go in this little shelving area, and this is kind of the area where I just grab, so like my everyday type of boots. And then on the top shelf I put more black shoes, black booties, and I actually got rid of enough shoes to where I could space them out nicely and not have them all crammed on the top shelf, which is something I've never experienced before. I've never had space between my shoes up here, so it was exciting. And then on the other shelving area, even more shoes. I know I have a problem, but I love black boots. They spark so much joy that I still got rid of some, so I'm not too mad about it. But yeah, I started putting the rest of my shoes here. So you'll see some color pop up because I do have some orange shoes and some purple docks, things like that I ended up putting here. And I did end up moving some shoes around as time went on. So you'll see the final result at the end. And here I decided to stack my Target little organizer things. and try something different since I had the space there, since I wasn't doing the jewelry thing anymore. Put some shoe boxes on the side for storage. And then I also found this little gift box that I had gotten around the holidays and decided to put my clutches in here. So any clutches, wallets, or just like little card holders that I use for my little clutches, like to put in there when I go out and stuff like that, I put in this little gift box. You can also use shoe boxes or whatever little box you have laying around. I didn't go buy anything special. I just used what I already had and just use that to store any clutches. So that I thought was a pretty good solution and something new to me that I at least thought I'd try out. And then in another one of those little storage or gift boxes, I think it's just like a holiday gift box, really, I decided to store my scarves. And these are more my neck scarves when I'm wearing a blazer or a leather jacket and want a little accent. So I just folded them up all nice and fancy until they fit in the little decorative box I was using for it. Once I get a shoebox, we'll do for this. And so far, I'm liking this so much better than my previous solution. So my previous solution was like a hanger that almost looked like a ladder, if that makes sense. And then you would just put your, you know, scarves, like kind of drape them over each of the, what do you call them, rungs? Is that what it's called? Of the ladder, you know what I mean? Or steps of the ladder kind of hanger situation. And I liked it, but the thing is, it was kind of bulky, honestly, because I tried to store a lot of scarves on there. And also the hanger was made out of this rubbery material, so my scarves were kind of sticking to it, and it just felt like it might snag on it, or my really nice delicate silk scarves would start snagging on it. So I thought folding it and putting it in a box would be better or easier on the scarves, especially my delicate scarves, and I could see them all lined up and be able to choose them really quickly instead of layering them on top of each other and things like that. So really excited to see how this works out, and I'll keep you posted as time goes on how it works out. So moving on, I am wiping down the IKEA drawers. I will have these linked in the description box for you, by the way, if I can find them. These IKEA drawers, I just wiped them down and made sure they were all nice and clean and not dusty or hairy or any of the things. And I am folding up my leggings because I'm going to be storing my leggings in these drawers, or one of the drawers. And so I'm just sitting here and taking my time listening to my podcast and folding my leggings. Honestly, when it comes to folding my leggings or anything, scarves, whatever it is, I just play around with different folds all the time because I don't know, I like to try new things and see if I can find a more efficient way or a way that I end up just liking better. Sometimes I don't always like it better. Sometimes I'm like, this was a terrible idea. I will say I do get a ton of inspo from the KonMari method or Marie Kondo, because her folding techniques are amazing. But I do switch up my folding all the time still, but I do typically keep her methods in mind. If you haven't heard of her methods, there's a show on Netflix, and I'm sure you can see it. Just look it up on the interwebs. Basically, she folds it in a way where the item can stand up on its own and then lines them up in a drawer to where you can see it right when you look in. Like if you open the drawer, you can see everything lined up so nothing is stacked on top of each other. So I kind of use her for inspo for sure. So that's kind of what you're seeing here. As I'm placing the leggings in the drawer, I kind of just line them up. So when I open the drawer, I can see everything right there. So the next drawer, I ended up using these dividers. I got these from the Container Store. Once again, I'll have it linked in the description if I can find it. And I decided to use this as a new thing, once again for me, to use this to store my tights. So my tights used to be in one of those cloth bins from Target, just a basic cloth bin, and just thrown in there. I didn't have any specific way to store it or have it all nice and neat looking. And honestly, every time I'd want to wear a pair of tights, I'd have to dig through the entire thing to find them. This solution I love so much. I basically just folded my tights and then rolled them up and then just tucked them into the little dividers. And honestly, it's amazing. I can see all of my tights there as soon as I open the drawer. They're all nice and organized, so they're not folding all over each other, all tangled up. So this might be my new favorite storage solution ever for this kind of thing. And the dividers themselves are customizable. So you can, if you have a smaller drawer, you can make it smaller. If you have a larger drawer, you can add more to it to where it, you can just customize it to what you already have, which I really like because you don't have to have a container store drawer to make it work. And so this is just an IKEA drawer and it worked perfectly. And I am so excited about this storage solution. I feel like this will be so much easier to keep up and see what I have and be able to see when my container is overflowing, when I need to start decluttering and getting rid of some things. And also this is really nice because a lot of times, like if I'm doing a try on or if I'm doing some sort of costume or cosplay, whatever, it'd be so nice to open this up and be like, oh, here's my sheer section and here's my opaque black tights and here are some gray tights. It's just so nice to be able to open it and just grab what you need. I'm so excited about this, obviously. Probably way too excited than is okay, but whatever. I love it. Moving on to the next set of little IKEA drawers. This little dresser or little drawer set ended up being more of a basics drawer. In the top drawer, I put anything that was smaller or daintier pieces, so little camis, tube tops, bodysuits, anything like that. So what I'm doing here is just folding it once again, taking a lot of inspo from Marie Kondo and folding them until they're in similar squares or rectangles, just similar sizes. So when I put them back into the drawer, I can line them up once again back to back and by color. Usually is what I do. And then that way when I open my drawer and I need to grab a basic, maybe I need to wear a cami under a sheer top or something, I can just reach in here and grab what I need. And in the bottom drawer, I put a couple of slips and some biker shorts and high-waisted panty kind of situations for anytime I'm wearing something sheer and need to reach for something. Also, any extra tights that were still in packages, also a sticky bra, double stick tape, those kind of things. All right, so in the last little IKEA dresser, I ended up putting all of my workout clothes in here, which actually were stored in another room, but now that I had space left and had gotten rid of so much stuff, I had empty drawers to put things. So I decided to bring my workout clothes in here. So on the top drawer, I have workout tops and sports bras. And then on the bottom drawer, I put all my workout leggings, which I'd already had folded up KonMari style in a shoebox. And then I added a pair of shorts and another pair of leggings on the side. And that's pretty much what I did. I'm really happy about this. Happy to have everything in one room finally. All right, so here I am bringing in my IKEA, is this the pack shelving unit? I can't remember which one this is. I'll have it once again linked in the description for you, but I have this shelving unit. This was the beginning of the end of my closet organization when I brought this downstairs around Halloween time. I'm glad I have this back in my closet so everything can be in order again, but I wiped it all down, got it all dusted off, and then just started folding my jeans. I love storing my jeans on here or in the little cubbies in here because I feel like it ends up looking kind of like a store. That's weird, like a retail store. So yeah, just folding my jeans, getting them stacked up, and then putting them away. So I put all of my dark denim or black denim mainly on the upper left-hand cube. And then on the upper right-hand cube, I ended up putting all my other jeans, mainly blue jeans, but I also had a white pair of jeans and a pink pair of jeans. But I ended up kind of storing them from light to dark. And I put the white pair of jeans by the light blue denim so they don't get dyed where it won't bleed onto the white. So that is kind of how I stored everything. All right, moving on to the other cubbies. All right, I was once again indecisive here. I started folding up my sweaters either way because I knew I was going to store them in either a cloth cubby thing. No, what is it? Bin. That goes in the cubby from Target or a woven one that I also had from Target a while back. So I guess I ended up putting it in the woven one, but I folded up all my sweaters and stored them in this little bin situation. Did the same thing with my other sweaters. Also, I don't know what my deal is with leaving tags on all of my bins, but I had to cut off so many tags that I've had these for some of them for years. So that's just my life, apparently. Anyways, just continuing to fold my sweaters and store them in a little bin. And then I ended up switching out how I did the bins. So I first had the gray cloth bins. One of them had my tennis shoes in them. And the other one I ended up putting hats in. Some of my husband's hats went in there. But then I ended up switching it out and put the white woven bins in the IKEA shelving system, and then I put the cloth gray ones in their proper Target storage system. something. All right, so then I hung up one of my sun hats and a couple of my fedora hats on some command hooks that I hung on the wall. And I had done that last time and really liked it. So that's from my last closet declutter. And then here I have an over the door hanger danger thing and was putting belts on there. All right, now I'm finally bringing in my clothes 500 years later and starting in the dark section of my closet and put anything that was longer, like longer dresses, kimonos, that kind of thing on the left hand side, and then worked my way shorter. So I went from longer dresses to shorter dresses, then to tunics, then to regular length tops, then to crop tops. And I did that because the further right you go in my closet, then I start running into that IKEA storage or, you know, the shelving system. So I can't put long items there without them looking all weird. So that's why I did it that way. I also went from where my dresses were, my longer dresses. I went from cami dresses to short sleeve dresses to long sleeve dresses to long sleeve tops, to short sleeve tops, to camis. That way all the long sleeve tops and dresses could all kind of be together. And short sleeve and camis, I could just, you know, maneuver around. But that's just how I did it. Once again, I'm always trying new things and experimenting to see what's working and what's not working. I might end up changing it later, but that's what I decided to do for now. So now I'm bringing in all the rest of my tops, and I am sticking with the Roy G. Biv action. If you watched my last closet declutter, I am still loving organizing my closet by color. At one point in time, I was storing everything by type. So all the long sleeves together, short sleeves together. But I realized that when I get dressed, what I think of first is what color I want to wear. So I want to wear a red top. So then I go to my red section. To where before it was like, I had to go look for red tops through every section, camis, t-shirts, long sleeve, to figure out what I wanted to wear. So I feel like this is kind of one of those things where it depends on preference, on what you think about when you're getting dressed. You think about what type of top or outfit you want to wear, or what color you want to wear. So that's just going to, I think, depend on the person. Maybe I'm wrong, but I totally think it does. So when I organize by color, I start on the left with, I do the whole Roy G. Biv thing. If you know Roy G. Biv, you know it's red, orange, yellow. Then I go to green, blue, indigo, violet. And then I go into, I think I do gray, white, brown. After that, I stored any black casual shirts, like anything that was a little bit longer, things I wear with leggings, but that are more like t-shirt or sweatshirt style. And then I go into my black and white pattern section, which I'm secretly proud of. I love that section so much. Also, as I'm organizing each color, I'll go by kind of a gradient. I'm weird about it. So I'll go from a light red to a dark red or burgundy to a burnt orange to a light yellowish orange. Then I'll go from mustard to a light yellow and so on and so forth until it's more like a gradient. It's super weird, but that's what I do. Also, side note, I'm still living for the felt hanger situation. I switched over to felt hangers a while ago and I cannot get over it. If you have not made the switch yet, I got mine off Amazon and it saves so much space. And here, I actually got rid of so many tops that I was able to add my flannels and blazers to my tops, which is really nice, because before I had way too, which I still have too many clothes, but I had way too many tops to where I had to store my blazers and flannels separate. So I love that I can have everything together. Okay, so moving on to the bottom rail, I have all of my denim jackets, leather jackets and coats, and faux fur coats. And these will stay here until late spring, early summer, and then I will move them or store them. This is where my blazers and flannels used to have to go. And now I have some extra space for my leather coats. All right, moving on, I'm just adding some finishing touches and storing like things like that little Killstar skull bag, a little jewelry box, and this little bust that I got and spray painted from Home Goods, and just added a little decor. And on the little drawers, my little IKEA drawers, I put a couple of pairs of shoes and a couple of handbags and just kind of added a couple pieces. I had some skirts that I needed to put up and just finishing touches. All right, so here is the before, which is an actual nightmare. Never letting it get like this again. And here is the after, and it feels so good. It feels so good. to have it done. All right, so I'm going to continue to show before and after shots, but I'm going to leave you here because I am done talking. Girl needs an icy cold beverage for these vocal cords or a warm tea beverage. Not sure yet, but I'm going to go figure that out. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can give it a thumbs up. Say hey, ghoul, hey down in the comments because you know I love talking to you. Also, let me know, I don't know, what you're decluttering, what space you're working on, or if you have any cleaning tips or organization tips or decluttering tips. I love geeking out about all the domestic things, so we can do that in the comments if you want. Also, I'm gonna link as much as I can down in the description for you in case you're looking for something. But if you do not see something that you're looking for, let me know in the comments as well. And yeah, anyways, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.